So welcome to this Sunday's Fearless Fundamentals video, and I'm excited to bring you this one. This one's going to be on a mental concept to help you grow in a weird sort of way faster by going slower. There's an old saying, slow down to go fast. You can think about it in the analogy of the tortoise and the hare. You know, the tortoise was all about speed, all at once, slamming the gas pedal down and going as fast as possible, whereas the tortoise was about consistency, 1% at a time, regular growth. And the tortoise ends up winning this race. And the analogy here is that you need to slow down to go fast. You need to be consistent or you'll burn yourself out, you'll crash, you'll be inconsistent. And inconsistency leads to actually going backwards. You start to go forward and then you crash, you go back, and it's constantly starting over, creating total burnout. And this is what a lot of people do when they grow. Now, I want to relate this to your process of growing with women and dating, because I see this so much with men, women, and dating. They go out and they want to learn to be good with women. And it's a lot of pressure because it's a major part of your self-esteem as a man. If I'm not attractive to beautiful women or attractive women or women I like, I can't get that woman in my dreams, I'm not valuable as a human being. That's kind of the feeling. So they become obsessed with getting that girl or getting a girl or getting girls or getting women. And they obsess so much that the wanting of it pushes them all away. There's this sense of, I'm coming at you, at the women. I've seen this a million times in bars. I'll be in bars and you can see all the guys hunting the women, and the women are closing off and pulling away. And as it gets later in the night, the more the women close off. I see it with pickup groups. I'll be in the bar and suddenly the anxiety raises in the room. That's because some pickup group came in that's teaching all the guys to push, 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 and eventually things will start to change. And that does work for a small group of men who are already kind of grounded, who just need to be pushed a little bit. But guys who have a lot of self-esteem, a lot of issues they're working through, a lot of deep pain they're working through, that doesn't work for it. It actually amplifies the pain more and more and more, causing them to push harder. The law of polarity, there's another law in there. And what it ends up doing is it ultimately causes them to burn out and then crash and then go all the way down into numbing out and apathy. And I've seen guys like this work for 5 years, 6 years, 7 years, 10 years, and they're no better with women, and most of the time worse than women, and worse with women than when they started. And I don't want you to be that guy. I want you to get this simple principle from the beginning. We talk about it all the time, the 1% rule. Grow 1% at a time, or what your body's comfortable at growing at, and honor that, respect that, celebrate that. And I'm going to show it to you through natural law. I'm going to show it to you through simple principles. Now, as I say this, I want to remind you guys that I was terrible in the beginning. I was absolutely horrible. Women would run the other way from me. Women did not want to date me. At best, they wanted to be my friend. And I had to do a lot of changing to even get started in this area. I had to shift myself a lot. I was really in my head. I was really analytical. I was really a big victim. So all of this stuff I'm asking you to do, I've done. I've been through. You can do it too. I had to surrender ultimately, and I wish I had done it sooner, to taking my time and going at the pace my body was ready to go at. And there's a law of gestation and a law of transmutation. So there's a couple other laws in there. Now what I'm referring to are the seven natural laws as I talk about this. And you can learn more about that in my video on the seven natural laws. It's on the YouTube channel. And we'll see if we can get a link in here, but you can. It comes up pretty quick if you look it up. It's a powerful video. It's got a lot of great comments, and I think if that is an addendum to this video, it can be awesome. So also, just so you understand where I came from, what I'm going to do here is I want to flash somewhere on this screen a picture of me, the way I used to look before I started all this, and how much I've changed. And you can really see the lack of embodiment, the disconnection from my body. And feel free to put a comment in there. I'd definitely love to read the comments on what you see in that picture. So now, getting back to the principle is very simple. You do need to take action. You do need to push your boundaries. You do need to step into tension. You do need to work on your vulnerability, all the stuff I talk about. You do need to work on your embodiment, but you're gonna grow a little bit each day. You think about a bodybuilder lifting weights. A bodybuilder doesn't instantly go from 150 pounds to 250 pounds. he has to grow a little bit each week. He also has to have the right nutrition, a lot of rest and recovery. He has to take action, bold action, to stress and damage the muscle just the right amount so they'll grow in response and adapt. And this is all the stuff that needs to be in place as you're shifting the mind too. The more you surrender to this process, the faster you will change. And that's the oxymoron. The more you try to rush this concept, the slower you will change. When I first started out, I used to think, I'm gonna get over my approach anxiety right away. I had terrible approach anxiety. So I'd go out to a bar and I'm gonna try to do 30 approaches tonight, and I'm gonna push. And by the end of the week, and then I'll do it tomorrow night, and by the end of the weekend, I'll be a new man and break free, break off all my bondage, and be really good at approaching women, or at least comfortable so I can get good at approaching women. I didn't even care about good. What typically happened was a little different. On the nights I got the balls to approach a lot of women, I had to repress the approach anxiety. I'd be shaking, I'd be nervous. Eventually body armor would come up and I would get ballsier, but it's because I wasn't feeling. And I would push. And then I would think, oh, wow, I did amazing tonight. I talked to all these girls. And then I'd do it again, try to do it again the next night. There was more resistance in the start. And I'd bust through it, do it again somewhat, maybe not 30. And then I'd think, wow, that had to have an effect on my approach anxiety. The next weekend would roll around, and I was more terrified than the weekend before. What I did was I polarized my nervous system, law of polarity, and caused it, as I pushed this way, way outside my comfort zone, I caused the aversion to become stronger. So the attachment to becoming free and powerful with approaching was so strong, and instead of dealing with that attachment, I activated more of an aversion. That's how the law of polarity works, where there's an up, there's a down, where there's a left, there's a right. Where something's 4 feet from left to right, there has to be 4 feet from right to left. So where there's a strong attachment, and this is a natural law, it's so true 100% of the time, that's what makes it a law. So if something is 4 feet from left to right, it has to be 4 feet from right to left, where there's male, there's female. So where I have an attachment to making something happen, there's also an aversion. That's why the attachment's there. There's a fight between the two. And you gotta deal with both sides to truly go free of it. The natural solution to this is to stop polarizing so much and work within my comfort zone. This doesn't mean I don't push my boundaries. This doesn't mean I don't step into vulnerability. It just means I step into the right amount. As I go to lift weights, for example, if I lift just the right amount of weight and really be conscious of the negatives, for example, like going down and go down slow, and then I can shoot up really good and then come down slow and really work those muscles. The other day I was doing like a 4 second down on my descent, and that really tears up the muscles, causes metabolic damage, and then plenty of rest to heal. And what I'm doing is being really present with the process and working right in my range, not giving bad form, not falling apart, and really pushing my boundaries at just the right level. This causes massive growth in the end, because I gave the body everything it needed in the right doses. And this is where everybody gets wrong. They try to do too much too fast, or they try to do too little, thinking, you know, I'm scared to do it, so I'm just barely gonna do any, but they have one toe in and one toe out. And it's really about fully committing to the right amount of tension and vulnerability. So how do you figure this out? Well, you go out there and you ask yourself, if I need to work on approaching today, for example, approaching a beautiful woman, and approaching that beautiful, beautiful woman over there is a 10 on the Richter scale. You know, I'm gonna blow up, I'm gonna die, and my head's gonna blow off, and telling her she's hot, and I think she's sexy, and I wanna get to know her. Well, that's not gonna work. It's not even probably gonna get a good response because I'm gonna be so reactive when I approach. So what I wanna do is find something that's nice and easy, that's a small progression from where I'm at. If zero is no tension, then what's a 3? Maybe a 4. 2s are fine too. I wouldn't even go up much above that, except on occasion, when I really want to push myself as a stretch. But most of the time, 2s, 3s, and 4s. I'll say, okay, what can I do to approach that beautiful girl, or to push myself in the direction of that beautiful girl that's a 2 or a 3 today? And then I'm going to go do it. I'm going to fully be present with the feelings and emotions that come up. And then I'm going to do either a releasing process or a journaling process. And then I'm going to let them go. And I'm going to walk away from those emotions. I'm going to drop them. And then do it again, and then do it again, and do it again. Maybe I'll do 4 or 5 approaches, maybe 10 or 20, then I'll journal about what's coming up for me. And then I'll also acknowledge how I'm improving, how I'm growing, what I did better. You got to constantly acknowledge the growth and the improvement and the successes and celebrate them. So I do the approach at the right tension level, vulnerability level, and then I acknowledge what I'm realizing from it, learning from it through journaling, and then I also celebrate what I did really good, how I grew, and I sit in that for a minute and appreciate it. It's like after having a good workout and you're like, wow, I feel great. I really pushed my body. I know my body's gonna grow from this. And then the next day you do it again. And the next day you do it again. Maybe you take an occasional day off. But with mind work, you can kind of be pretty darn consistent. And at the end of a month, 2 months, 3 months, you can have a radical shift in your growth. What are some laws, if laws are true 100% of the time, that we're working here? Well, we're getting the polarity in the right range. We're not causing this massive polarization, which causes the pain to activate massively. We're also working with the law of gestation. When you're working on something, it's gonna take a period of time. Making a baby takes 9 months. Working in this area of growth is gonna take a period of time. The more dense my thinking is, the more pain I'm in, the more I'm judging myself, beating myself up, the longer it's gonna take to process those emotions. I have to be present with them. I have to work with them. I have to relax into them. And the more fluid my beliefs are, the more relaxed I am, the more work I've done in the past, the more I have really good foundation, the faster I'm gonna go. And where you're at is where you're at. I was way behind the eight ball. I was super negative, super hard on myself. So it took longer and I had to go slower. Law of gestation applied there. And it was a lot of work. And that was great. It's fine. Because once I accepted that, it actually started to move pretty fast because the full acceptance of that idea causes the growth to speed up. So I want you to kind of let that idea in too. The next law I want you to play with, so we got three laws here, law of polarity, law of gestation, and the law of transmutation. The law of transmutation states that as you work through something, especially if it's low and heavy on the emotional scale, like apathy, grief, and fear, you're gonna have an emotional response that's intensifying. It's like intensification. You're gonna feel something bubble up. You're gonna feel this weirdness or something you don't like. Something's gonna change. Just like the phoenix burning up and being reborn, the mythology of the phoenix, imagine being the phoenix and suddenly lighting on fire. It seems like everything's going wrong. You're burning up, but then you're reborn better than ever before. Same with the caterpillar. Caterpillar turns into a cocoon, turns into goo, falls completely apart, and then is reborn a butterfly. Well, we all do this. As we go through some of the lower emotions and then we finally surrender to them and let them go, we're reborn better than ever before. There's a transmutation that happens there. So it's the law of transmutation, which has an intensification, weird feelings. At the higher level, it just feels good. It feels like you feel yourself processing and you're going through something because you understand it. You've been through it. You get it. This is perfect. At the lower level, it feels kind of like you're going backwards to go forward. And that's perfectly fine too. Realize that happens and learn from it and process it. And don't make it wrong. What happens in the law of transmutation where we go wrong, like in gestation, the law of gestation, it's not going fast enough. In the law of transmutation, we think there's something wrong in all these emotions and feelings that we're experiencing. There must be something wrong. I'm feeling all this sadness and this grief instead of just processing and letting it go and realizing that stuff coming out of your subconscious to be released. So, and in the law of polarity, we're trying to push too far too fast. Also, we're stretching and we're causing the opposite side of the polarity to activate, the aversion to grow stronger. So as you work each one of these, you begin to wake up and realize that growth is not a hard process at all if you work within the natural laws. And if you just think about these three natural laws, there's seven I talk about in that video, but if you think about these three, you can have a big shift in your reality fairly quickly. Give yourself a month to 3 months and look back and see how much you shifted. I would say each day as you journal how you're growing and then look back at all the things you've journaled, start to track all your gains and successes along this month to 3 month journey, you'll really see a powerful process of transmutation happening overall. The big picture will start to come together around approaching or whatever else you want to work on. So to me, this was one of the most important things I ever did and got in alignment with, and I get all my clients in alignment with, is that you're gonna grow at the rate you're gonna grow. And the more you surrender to that, the faster you grow. And that's a weird oxymoron, but it's so true. And once you surrender to that, it all becomes more pleasurable and fun anyways. You get to learn from every step, and the next thing you know, you have a whole new life and a whole new way of being. You literally change who you're being. It's like the phoenix, you burn up to be reborn better than ever before. Really powerful. For those of you that are Christian, it's the same analogy of Jesus on the cross, you know, being to the cross and you know, God, why hast thou forsaken me? Then dying and then being reborn better than ever before. That's what that analogy in my mind represents. It's very powerful. And when you start to understand that, you understand that's what we go through with every trauma and drama in life, that we face it. We don't become a victim to it. We penetrate through it. We show up anyways at just the right amount. We just stay present. And then what happens is there's a transmutation process that happens. We don't take that personal. We're reborn more confident than before. And we keep doing this. Same with bodybuilding. Damage the muscle, rest, feed the right nutrition, repair, and the body becomes stronger and bigger. Same with developing flexibility. Same with everything. You see it everywhere. So I want to invite you into this process. It's the 1% rule, which is something else I wanted to talk about in this video. It's the 1% rule in action. If you can just honor these 1% gains, compounding interest is radical. And if you think about compounding interest and you look at a compounding interest chart, you can look one up on Google, or if we can get one up here, we'll get one up here. But if not, you can look one up on Google. At one penny a day, doubled every day, in 31 days, you have over $10 million, okay? One penny doubled every day. And it looks like nothing's happening along the way, but at the end of that doubling, there's a skyrocketing effect. That's where the quantum leap happens. At first, it looks like nothing's happening, but through 1% a day, there's an eventual quantum leap that blows your life up and everything changes. And this happens overall with your whole life. When you get in alignment with everything I just talked about through your whole life, not just with dating, your money reality, your health reality, And you start getting all of these different areas compounding at 1% using these natural laws. What happens is one day you look back and you're like, wow, I'm a whole different human being. And it will only keep getting better from there. So if you really want a radical change, watch this video over. Watch it several times. Watch it throughout the process. Commit to a month, 2 months, 3 months, and keep rewatching it and getting more subtle realizations about everything I talked about. Check out my 7 natural laws video. Keep a compounding interest chart. Keep reminding yourself about it. Look at that original picture of me and get a feel and look at how much I've changed since I started this process, and realize that change is not only possible, it's inevitable when you work within the natural laws. So with this said, I hope you like this video. I would love to hear your comments on it, because this one's personal to me. It's very powerful to me. It's how I changed my life. And share the video. I'd love for you to share the video to anybody that needs this, man, woman, child, in different areas of life. Help them to understand what it takes to truly change. And smash that like button if you liked it, and subscribe. And with that said, remember, only the confident really live. I'll see you in the next video. Have a beautiful day, beautiful week. Take care.